Hi, my name is Diego, and I'm 16 years old. What I like to do the most is sports, no matter which one, but my favorites are skiing, surfing and climbing. In addition to having hobbies related to sports or physical activities, I really like reading and traveling. That is why I consider myself a global citizenship, and I am doing this project to try to go to Netherlands to have another experience that fills my person and mind and help me to develop my identity. Who am I? Well, this is a good question, and if I tell the truth, I wouldn't know what to answer exactly. But if I had to answer now, I would say that I am any human quite curious who likes above all to experience new things, to try new sensations.
I am a son of Marta and Diego. Friend of Aaron, Dario, Alex, Diego, etc. Grandson of Joaquin and Carmen. A student of Fabiola, Eva, Marola, Javi, etc. Brother of Vida, Daniela, Edric, and along etc. of people. All these people are the ones I interact with every day, and from this I can deduce that my personality and therefore who I am depends a lot on the people I surround myself with.
So, therefore, one way to answer the question is to show the relationships and connection that I have with people. As Aristotle said, the human being is a social being. This means that we need the company and existence of other people to survive. The human being, by the simple fact of having conscience and living in society, has a series of values that define each person as he is. And that is unique and unrepeatable individual. This is very related to the identity of each person. These values or attributes can be of many types, but the ones that attract my attention are adventure, friendship, curiosity, achievements, and happiness.
For adventure, I think it is one of my fundamental values because I am always thinking about new things to do, to such an extent that as soon as I finish high school, I want to study aerospace engineering for in the future to be an astronaut and go to space. This is my biggest dream and goal to achieve. Being an astronaut is part of the achievements, as it is the greatest goal to which I aspire. In addition, by nature, I am quite curious, and that leads to a constant search for information to try to understand the reality that surrounds me, and thus be able to make some discovery or participate directly or indirectly in some to be able to leave my grain of sand in favor of progress of humanity. The last two values for me go together, as I believe that one cannot reach one without the other. Friendship, as this time is what I spend the most time, because I think that with good friends, with whom to be able to do activities, talk, be a point of support, it is very easy to achieve happiness. Therefore, for me to be happy, that I believe that is the purpose for in person, it is friendship and the pursuit of my dream.
In my opinion, the principal issues that connect and separate people are money and death. Money often separates people with whom you have spent your childhood and create new friendship in line with your new purchasing level. So, many people base their relationships with other people by the money that they have and not for the person's own personality. This is because we live in a consumerist society, which only cares about material goods and think that this is how they will achieve happiness. But this is achieved by surrounding you with good people, and if you only base your connection with other people based on your money, you will never reach happiness. Death, unfortunately, also connects and relates people. For example, when my grandfathers died, attend the whole family, far and near, and also friends. But for these connections to be made, someone had to die, and I find it sad that we have a problem of such magnitude to connect to people, because we only think of ourselves.
In addition, all these values that belong to your identity also develop differently depending on where you were born or living. For example, I live in Spain, which belongs to Europe, and this continent is the healthiest according to the data of the average life expectancy that are extracted from each country. This means that we don't have to worry about many things, such as finding food, something that countries in Africa is their day to day. The problem is that this fact causes us to live in a bubble and not realize what it happens in the world. If I lived in another country in Europe like Netherlands, I would hardly notice the difference because there are more similarities than differences. But if I had born in the Democratic Republic of Congo, I would not have the same life as here. And surely my I, is to say my identity and my relationships with people, would change. For example, I could not dream of being an astronaut because of my possibilities would prevent me. This makes me rethink many things and position myself more in favor of global citizenship as a fair system with the same opportunities for everyone. But unfortunately, because of how the world is raised, poor countries are needed for the rich to advance scientifically and economically. And as I mentioned before, money creates relationships, and rich countries will want to relate to rich and will set aside the poor, which is a mistake.